Hey, Scorpio Risers, it's your soul coach, Jeremy Ryden, helping you to heal deeply so you can live fully. Why so much drama surrounding people that have Scorpio ascents? You know what I'm talking about. If you're a Scorpio Riser, you probably have had people lie on you, cheated on you, project their problems on you. You've had people misinterpret your motivations, accuse you of things that are clearly not your intention. Why do you find yourself in situations where people always feel compelled to include you in their drama and ask for your help? And then when you start helping the situation, they turn on you as if you're the reason why it happened to begin with. Now, I want to let you know that this is a real thing that can discourage and hurt and personally damage Scorpio Risers if they don't understand why this is happening to them at this time. If you are born with Scorpio on the ascent, you are what I call part of the collective healers, the collective consciousness on this planet. Now, there's a lot of people, everyone has personal planets, right? We got Venus and Mars and Mercury. These are personal planets that deal with the Earth in a very normal way, a very specific way. But people that have an outer planet, Neptune, Uranus, and Pluto, on the ascent, these are what I call collective people on this planet. They're not just living their life personally, but they're going through life dealing with all the drama, pain, hurt, confusion of all past people, ancestors, you name it. You're picking up on the vibration of everyone who's ever been on the planet as a collective whole, and you've been the what we call the universal garbage dump. Now, that doesn't sound as nice as saying you're a healer, but in this life, a lot of the healing you deal with is having to process all the taboos, all the painful subjects, and the unfair things that people don't want to talk about. Why? Because you're in the eighth house. Is part of your identity. What is the eighth house? If you're a Scorpio Riser, you know, that's, you know, sex, death, taxes, things that we don't want to talk about, you know. And so you get projected onto you. Just even if you never open up your mouth and you start a new job, before too long, people just start to hate you for no reason. Not everybody. Some people either love you or hate you. But the people that hate you for no reason normally are afraid that you're going to expose something. They don't even realize that they're hiding something in their own heart, but they subconsciously know that if they're around you long enough, you're going to find them out. So what does someone who feels guilty do? What do they do? They distract. And the way they distract is making noise about somebody else. If we put all eyes on the Scorpio Rising person, it'll take attention off of everyone else looking at what that person's doing wrong because he's pointing the finger at you. Most of the people that are pointing fingers at you are because they have issues that they're hiding and they're just subconsciously trying to protect themselves because they know that there's something powerful about you that can deal with the issues. So I don't want you to always have to find yourself in situations where if you go from one job to the next, you seem to be in the midst of scandals. You'll see this, that a lot of times scandals pop up around you. Why? Because you can handle crisis. Eighth house people, which is what you are, because you're Scorpio Rising, people that have Pluto as the ruler, they deal with a lot of crisis. They deal with a lot of psychological issues. That means the people in your family that are emotionally unhealthy, they're going to take it out on you because why? You can see what's really going on with that person if you don't take it personally. So my advice to Scorpio Risers who are the collective healers on the planet is what, like what I just said, don't take things personally. I know it's hard not to be upset when they're lying, projecting their problems onto you, when you're being dealt with unfairly, but you have to not believe the lies that you hear about yourself. You have to stand your ground and realize this is not my issue. This is not my problem. I'm not going to embrace it in my heart as if it is my problem just because it's being projected onto me. So part of the things I would tell young Scorpios is it's not your responsibility to heal everybody. So that means every problem that comes to your doorstep doesn't mean you have to open up your door and accept that as your responsibility. Become more wiser about the things you're going to get involved in. Sometimes it's just not worth helping certain people, because to help them is to hurt yourself. So I'm not telling you, though, that you should never help and never try to heal, because that is part of who you are. But I'm telling you to be more wise about it. So what will make you more wise? Setting up healthy boundaries. Boundaries. Asking yourself, is what I'm feeling right now, is that my issue? Or is that my mom, my brother, my coworker? Are they just projecting their problem onto me? I need to really look at this feeling and see, is this how I really feel? Or am I just embracing the energy of other people that are trying to pull me into their drama? You'll find out that probably 90% of the things that you feel that are dragging you down is because you're allowing the reality of other people to become your reality. It's their problem, not your problem. And so you could say, well, Jeremy, it is my problem when I'm being lied on, cheated. Don't focus on that, because if you focus on that, you'll internalize becoming a victim. You'll internalize that hurt. If you'll start practicing not being drawn into everybody's drama, start practicing boundaries of not accepting every emotion that's come to you, you'll become much more healthy, and you'll create a shield around you that says to the universe, listen, I'm not taking everybody's junk. So thank you, Scorpio Risers. I know that for a lot of you, it is not an easy life. I know a lot of you have had trauma and pain. You can heal that. How do you heal that? Well, talk therapy. It would be good for you to talk about your past. Talk about your childhood. You know, as Scorpios, a lot of times we don't want to talk about it with anybody else. So journal it. Put it on paper. But psychology, psychoanalysis, is very good for a Scorpio Risers, because once again, it's an eighth house issues that we are masters of. And so astrology, tarot, you name it, anything in the metaphysical books, read metaphysical books. These types of ancient teachings will empower you, because it will show you exactly what's going on in your life, where you understand that you're not being beaten up because you're weak or bad. You're facing these obstacles because you're actually good and powerful. So if you've not subscribed, hit the button below. I'm going to be doing a lot of things to help Scorpios and a lot of other astrology and other higher realm topics. My name is Jeremy Ryden. I'd like to be your soul coach.